बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम, वेलकम टू द क्लास ऑफ मशीन डिज़ाइन इन कैड वन। एंड आर टुडेज लेक्चर इज़ अबाउट द डिज़ाइन ऑफ द रिवेटेड जॉइंट्स। सो इन आर लास्ट लेक्चर वी हैव स्टडीड द पैरामीटर्स एंड बेसिक थियरीज विच आर रिलेटेड विद द रिवेटेड जॉइंट्स। इन द लास्ट लेक्चर वी हैव ऑल्सो लर्न दैट वट आर द टाइप्स ऑफ द परमानेंट फास्टनिंग्स आर द परमानेंट जॉइंट्स and what are the temporary joints. Then we studied the method of the riveting, either it's cold hardened or hot forged. Then the material used, this is the boiler section in which this is basically the section of the riveting. In bridge construction, rivets are also used. These were some essential qualities, or you can say that the thresholds or the minimum requirements for the rivets. And these were basically the types of the rivets according to the shape of the head. Like we have snap head rivet, we have pan head rivet, we have mushroom head, we have countersunk head, we have flat countersunk head, we have flat countersunk head of 60 degree, 90 degree, round countersunk of 60 degree and flat heads. And these are the fixed parameters. Here if you talk about a snap head, this is basically the dia of the snap head. And this head is of 1.6 times of the dia, and this head height is basically 0.5 times of the dia of the rivet. So these terms are according to the shape. If we talk about the pan head, in case of pan head, if d is the dia of your rivet, then this bulge out portion is equal to 1.6 times of the dia, and this head thickness, you can say that, or the head height, this is also 0.7 times of dia. So that's how rivets are joined. Then we talk about the joints. Basically we learn two types of the joints: lap joints and the butt joint, and the single riveted joints and the double riveted joints, and the terms related to them. There were some important terms that were used, like pitch, what is back pitch, what is diagonal pitch and marginal pitch. And these were two process, calling and fullering, that are used for filling of the material, or you can say that to make a rivet joint leak proof. There were basically three modes of the failure of the rivet joint. First one was the tearing of the plate, second one was the tearing of the plate across the row, and third one basically shearing of the rivet. So these were basically the types of the failure and the crushing of the rivets. And basically there were three types of the forces, that resistant forces PT, PS and PC. P is basically the resistance tensile force for the failure, second was the shearing force for the failure, and third one was the crushing failure force, or the resistance to the crushing failure. And in last, that was basically the efficiency of the riveted joint. And efficiency is basically least of these three parameters, PT, PS and PC, divided by the strength of the riveted joint, that is basically P, that is pitch, multiplied by the thickness, multiplied by sigma into t. Here p is not pitch, basically it is it's pitch, sorry. So now we'll go to the example, and here we solve. This is the first numerical problem which is related to the design of the rivet joint. So the statement is, a double riveted lap joint is made between 15 mm thick plates. The rivet diameter and the pitch are 25 millimeters and 75 millimeters respectively. If the ultimate stresses are 400 megapascals in tension, 320 megapascals in shear, and 640 megapascals in crush or crushing, find the minimum force per pitch which will rupture the joint. So in this design problem, we have been given with the thickness of the plate that are to be joined, and the here the thickness of the plate small t is 15 millimeters. The dia of the rivet is also given, small d is 25 millimeters, and the small p, that is basically the pitch is 75 millimeters. Now the ultimate tensile stress for tension, yani ke sigma tu that is 400 megapascals, in shear tau u is 320, and in crushing sigma cu or sigma bu, crushing or bearing, these are two names, you can use any of them, that is 640 megapascals. Now, as we know that there are three kind of resisting forces or the tearing forces, one is the tensile tearing force, second is the shearing tearing force, and third one is the crushing. So we'll calculate these three forces, and the least of which will be used for the design purpose. So the minimum force per pitch which will rupture the joint, since the ultimate stresses are given, therefore we shall find the ultimate value of the resistance of the joint. We know that ultimate tearing resistance per pitch, that would be equals to PT of U, that is equals to P minus D into T, that is basically area multiplied by the stress. This stress is basically the ultimate stress in the tension or the tearing stress, whose value was 400 megapascals. So we'll put these values here. P, small p, is basically the pitch, 75 minus D, here is the dia, 25 multiplied with plate thickness, which was 15 millimeters, multiplied by 400, that was ultimate stress in tension. Here the value of PT, ultimate tearing resistance force, is 300,000 newtons, or we can say that 300 kilonewtons. Now the second force will be of shearing. In shearing, the formula is N multiplied by pi by 4 into D square. Here N is basically the number of the rivets. It's a double riveted lap joint. It means that here N is multiplied by 2. So 2 multiplied by pi by 4 into D square. Here the stress is used, as this is the case of the shear, so we'll use the value of the shear stress, that is 320. So the ultimate shearing resistance in that case is 314,200 newton, that is 314 kilonewton, which is bit higher than this force. Now the ultimate crushing, the formula is N multiplied by D into T into sigma of crushing. Here N is the number of the rivets. Here the number of rivets are 2 multiplied by dia, that is 25, into thickness, that is 15. And the crushing stress value 640. Here the value is 480 kilonewtons. So the minimum of these three value is 300. So from above C, we see that the minimum force per pitch which will rupture the joint is 300 kilonewton or 300,000. So we'll design the rivet for this value, because this is the minimum value which it can resist. Okay. So this is the first portion. In second, if the above joint is subjected to a load such that the factor of safety is 4, here the FOS value is given as 4, find out the actual stresses develop in the plate and the rivet. So if the margin of the factor of safety is 4, what will be the actual value of these stresses, these three stresses, 400, 320 and 640, these are the values of ultimate stresses. So if we are giving a factor of safety is 4, we want to find what will be the actual value of these for these given forces. Now the actual stresses produced in the blades and the rivets. Since the factor of safety is 4, therefore safe load will find. First of all, we calculate the load, the design safe load. Here there are basically three values, 300 kilonewtons, 340 and 480 kilonewtons. As we said that we'll design it for 300 kilonewton, because this is the minimum value which it can bear. So we'll divide it with factor of safety to find out the actual value, that is 75,000 newtons. Now we'll calculate the actual value of the stresses, sigma ta for tension case, tau a for shearing case, and sigma ca for crushing case. Here the formula is P, that is equals to P minus D into T into sigma TA. Here the value of the P is 75,000 newtons. This value is given here. Now P is the pitch, that is 75, D is the dia, that is 25, and T is thickness, 15. Here the value of the stress in tension is 100 newtons per mm square or 100 megapascals. Similarly, the actual shearing stress value would be given as P, that is 75,000, and multiplied by pi by 4 into d square. Here we have two reverts, so that is 2 pi by 4 into d square into sigma into tau a. Here the value of the shearing resistance or the shear stress value is 76.4 megapascals. And in last we have the crushing stress value, again 75,000 n minus n multiplied by d into t. Here we'll put the values, and the final value for the crushing stress is 100 megapascals. So these three are the actual stresses for this bunch of factors of safety. What does it mean? It means that here the material can withstand, or the ultimate stresses in the material that is used for the riveting purpose is 400, 320 and 640. From these and the thickness of the plate, dia of the rivet, we have calculated the load which is basically applied, or we can say that the shearing resistance with the material can bear. That was the minimum value of 300,000. So by giving the factor of safety, we have calculated the actual amount of the force that have been upon each rivet, that is 75,000 newton, and we have calculated the stresses value 100, 76 and 100. These values are far less than these three values. It means that our design is a safe design. We go to the next example. A double riveted double cover butt joint. Here in this case, it's a double riveted and double covered butt joint. It's not a lap joint. So we have upper and bottom plate to cover it. Here the thickness of the plate is 20 mm. And the dia of the rivet is 2500 mm. And the pitch is 100 mm. The permissible stresses are sigma P, that is in tensile, 120 megapascals in shearing. The value is 100 megapascals, and in crushing the value is 150 megapascals. Find the efficiency of the joint taking the strength of the rivet in double shear as twice than that of single shear. So the given parameters are thickness of the plate is 20 mm, dia of the rivet is 2500 mm. Pitch of the rivet is 100 mm, sigma T is 120 megapascals, shear value is 100 megapascals, and crushing value is 150 megapascals. So first of all, we calculate the tearing resistance. Again, the formula is same, PT is equals to P minus D into T multiplied by sigma T. All the values are given here. Here P is 100 minus 25 multiplied by 20 multiplied by 120. Here the value is 180 kilonewtons or 180,000 newtons. Now the value for the shearing resistance is N multiplied by 2 multiplied by pi by 4 into D square. Here it's a double cover, double strength, double riveted joint. So N multiplied by 2 into pi by 4. Number of rivets are 2. And number of riveted joints are 2. It means that two rows, and we have basically two rows for that. This is basically 2, and for n we have number of rows that is basically 2. So the formula would be n multiplied by 2 multiplied by pi by 4 into d square. So 2 multiplied by 2, that is basically 4, pi by 4. Here 4 would be cancel out this 4. So pi multiplied by 25 square into 100, that value is 196.3 kilonewtons. Now we calculate the crushing resistance. Formula is N multiplied by D into T into sigma C. Here double riveted joints, two rivets are taken. So 2 multiplied by 25 into 20. Here the value is 150 kilonewtons. So we'll, in case of efficiency, we take the least of the value from PT, PS and PC. So we'll go back to the previous slide. Here the value of PT is 180. Second value is 196, which is a bit high value, and third value is 150. So the smallest of them is basically 150. So this joint will fail under the crushing resistance. value is 150 kilonewton. So we'll design it for 150. So the efficiency, we know that for the efficiency we'll take the least value divided by the strength of the unriveted or the solid plate, which is basically P multiplied by T into sigma T. Here P is basically the pitch multiplied by thickness, 20 into 100 multiplied by sigma T, that is basically 120. So the value is 240 kilonewtons. So 150 kilonewtons divided by 240 kilonewtons, the efficiency of this specific rivet joint is 62.5%. Now, third case. In third case, a double riveted, double cover butt joint in plate of 20 mm thickness is made with 25 mm diameter and the rivet of 100 mm pitch. The permissible stresses are 120, 100 and 150. Find the efficiency taking the strength of the rivet in the double shear as twice of the single shear. Here all the parameters are same just like the previous example. Value of the stresses are given in case of tensile stress, shearing and the crushing. Plate thickness is also given, the dia of the rivet is also given and pitch is also given. You have to find out the efficiency. So first of all, you will calculate the tensile resistance force, that is sigma T, that is P of T. Then you will calculate the shearing resistance, that is sigma S, P of S, and then for the crushing P of C. Then you will design it for least of these three values. The value, the minimum value you will take, and then you will divide it with unriveted joint whose strength formula is this P multiplied by T into sigma of T. So you will divide it by this, and that's how you will calculate the efficiency of this unriveted joint. Next example, a single riveted joint. A single riveted lap joint is made with 15 mm thick plate. Okay, the plate size is 15 mm with 20 mm diameter. Here the dia is 20 mm. Determine the strength of the joint if the pitch of the rivet is 60. Sigma T is 120 megapascals. Tau is 90 megapascals and sigma C is 160 megapascals. So we'll try to solve this question. Now, it's basically a lap joint. Here we have first plate. And this we have the second plate, and this is our rivet which have been inserted here. So according to the given parameters, the plate thickness is 15 mm, dia of the rivet is 20 mm. Also, it's a single riveted lap joint. Here the value of pitch, small p, is 60 mm. All the dimensions are in millimeters. And the stress values are sigma T, tau and sigma C. 120, 90 and 160. 120, 90 and 160. This is sigma T, this is tau, and this is sigma C. So what you will do in that case, first of all you will calculate P of T from this value of stress. Here the formula for PT is P minus B multiplied by the thickness multiplied by sigma of T. So the value is, here the pitch value is 60 minus dia, that is 20. Here this value is 15 and sigma t is 120. Keep one thing in mind, all these parameters are in mm and these test values are in megapascals. So either you will convert megapascals into pascals and millimeters into meters, or you will take this value as 120 and millimeters in millimeters. So this value will be in, the value of PT would be in Newton. So we will calculate from the calculator 60 minus 20, that is 40, multiplied by 15, which is 600, multiplied with 120, that is 72,000. This value is 72,000 newtons, or we can say that 72 kilo newtons. Second formula for shearing. Here the value of, we'll take a second sheet. Here the value for P of S, that is equals to pi by 4 d square multiplied by tau of S. Because it's a single riveted joint, that's why that is n here is 1. So if you write it or not, it's okay. So value of pi 4, here the value of d square. Die is 20, so 20 square multiplied with 90. So we'll calculate this value as well. So the value is 20 square, that is 400 multiplied with pi, that is 1256.63 divided by 4, 314.15 multiplied by 90. Here the value is 28,274.3 newton, or we can say that 28.2 kilonewton. This is basically the second value. Now we calculate it for the crushing. Here P for crushing, PC is equals to D into T multiplied by sigma C, and here N. N is 1, so it's your choice, you will write it or not. We'll confirm that formula from the previous example also. Yes, N into D into D. Okay. So that is 20 multiplied with 15 multiplied with 160. So we'll calculate it. 20 multiplied by 15 multiplied with 160. Here the value is 48,000 newton. Or 48 kilonewtons. So here we have three design values. One is 72 kilonewton, second one is 28 kilonewton, and the third one is 48 kilonewton. Here the minimum value is 28 kilonewton, that is in shearing. So this rivet, single rivet lap joint, will fail under shearing. So you will design this rivet for this value. Yeah, you always take the minimum value, because the rivet will fail under the minimum value among these all three. चलें आगे चलते हैं. ये हमने कर लिया. Next, two plates of 16 mm thickness are joined by a double riveted joint. Again, it's a lap joint. The pitch of the each row of the rivet is 90 mm. Here the pitch have been given. The rivet diameter is 25. The dia of the rivet is also given. The prisonal stresses are also given. Sigma T is 140. Tau is 110 megapascal. And sigma C is 240 megapascal. Find the efficiency of the lap joint. You have to find the efficiency of this lap joint. All the parameters are given. First of all, you will calculate these three resistance values: tensile resistance, shearing resistance, and crushing resistance. That are basically P of T, P of S, and P of C. Then you will use the minimum of these three values and you will calculate the value for the unriveted joint or the base plate. Then you will divide the minimum of these three values divided by the unriveted strength. That would be your efficiency for this kind of lap joint. In next example, a single riveted double cover butt joint. Here it's a single riveted but a double cover butt joint. Here the value of thickness is 10 and the dia is 20 and the pitch is 60. You have to calculate the efficiency again. Here these three parameters are given. So for you will calculate the P of S, P of C and P of D and then divide it with unriveted joint to get the value of the efficiency in this case also. In next example, a double riveted cover joint, it's a butt cover joint, double covered or double riveted. In 12 mm thickness plate, 18 mm diameter, again you have to calculate the efficiency, the pitch is given, the stresses are given. It's a similar kind of example. In next question, a double riveted lap joint. It's a double riveted but not double covered. It's a double riveted lap joint. It's a lap joint, that's why it's not double covered or single covered because of the overlapping. With chain riveting is to be made. In chain riveting, the adjacent rows, the position of the rivets are same. It's not a zigzag pitch. It's basically the pitch we will use is basically the back pitch. A double riveted lap joint in the chain riveting is to be made for joining of the two plates of 10 mm thick. Here the thickness is given. The allowable stresses sigma T is 60 megapascals. Tau is 50 megapascals and sigma C is 80 megapascals. Find the dia of the rivet. You have to calculate the dia of the rivet in that question. Pitch of the rivet. Pitch of the rivet, these ke andar calculate karni hai and distance between the rows of the rivet. Aur jo rows ke andar distance hai, wo bhi aapne calculate karna hai. Then you have to find out the efficiency of the joint as well. Theek hai ji? That is your assignment for the next week. A triple riveted lap joint. In that case, there are three rows and that are in the staggered position with the zigzag riveting to be designed. Here the thickness of the plate is 6. The dia, pitch of the rivet and the distance between the rows that you have to calculate. Indicate how the joint will fail. आपने बताना है कि किस कंडीशन के अंदर ये जॉइंट जो है ये फेल होगा इन तीनों में और स्ट्रेसेस की वैल्यू जो है वो भी इसके अंदर आपको दी गई है. सो ये दो क्वेश्चंस आपके इंपॉर्टेंट हैं. दीज आर योर होम असाइनमेंट्स. सो हियर इज एन इंटरेस्टिंग फैक्ट. सो हाउ मेनी रिवेट्स आर इन एन एफल टावर. कभी आपने गौर किया है कि एफल टावर का जो आपके पास ब्रिज है उसके अंदर कितने रिवेट्स यूज हुए हैं. सो हियर इज द आंसर. There are 25 lakhs rivets that are used in construction of the Eiffel Tower with 18,038 iron parts. So this is the amount in dollars and it is visible from 42 miles. Yani ki itna bada hai ki aap isko 42 miles door se dekh sakte hain. 4 tons of cleaning clothes and 400 liters of detergent and 25,000 bin bags are used for the cleaning. And if you flat it upon the ground, so ye aapke paas kuch bante hain 1660 yards or 1660 steps. The thermal expansion of the bridge is 18 centimeters and the sways are 6-7 centimeters. Thermal expansion means ke jab heat hota hai garmiyon ke andar ya aapka temperature jo hai badhta hai इतने बड़े आपके टावर के अंदर जो एक्सपेंशन है दैट इज ओनली 18 सेंटीमीटर बिकॉज ऑफ द सॉलिड पार्ट। द स्वेज मीन्स कि जब आपके पास आंधियां आती हैं उसकी वजह से ये लेफ्ट राइट जो स्विंग हो सकता है उसकी जो कैपेसिटी है दैट इज 6 to 7 सेंटीमीटर। सो दैट इज ऑल फ्रॉम टूडेज लेक्चर। आई होप आपको इस लेक्चर की जो है अच्छी तरह से समझ आई होगी। और यहाँ पे हमारा जो रिवेटिंग का पोर्शन है वो कंप्लीट होता है। एंड दीज आर बेसिकली फ्रॉम स्लाइड 25। ऑल आर होम असाइनमेंट्स ये आपने नेक्स्ट टाइम जो है ये सॉल्व करके लानी है। दिस एग्जाम्पल एंड दीज क्वेश्चन 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 These are the 7 questions that are related to different kind of rivet joints, and there are different kind of parameters and the design procedure that you will adopt. Or next class ke andar jo hai, you will submit this assignment. So that is all from today's lecture. Thank you so much. Allah Hafiz.